Congratulations on your new Volkswagen. I'm sure you're going to love it. To help you get the most out of your VW, I'm going to show you some key features and functions. So let's get started. First up, the keyless access system. With the key fob with you, unlock by slipping your hand in the handle and lightly touching the back. You should hear the vehicle unlock, then pull the handle to open. By using the infotainment system, you can choose whether you want just the driver's door, the doors on one side only, or all of the doors to unlock. Locking is just as easy. With the ignition off, just close the door and touch the outside of the handle. You should hear the vehicle lock and the turn signals will flash once. Loading groceries isn't fun when your hands are full. Enter the Easy Open feature. With the key fob in your pocket or bag, swing the lower part of your leg in, then out, near the center of the bumper without touching it. Voila, hands-free access. To close, simply repeat the kick motion near the center of the bumper and walk away. The hatch will close once you're clear. Okay, let's go over a few things inside the vehicle. With keyless ignition, just press and hold the brake pedal and push the engine start button in the console. To turn off the engine, put the vehicle in park, engage the parking brake, and press the button again. If you want to use some electrical features with the engine off, just press the engine start button without pressing the brake. It's time to talk about setting the clock. Go to the vehicle menu in the infotainment system, then settings. Then choose time and date. You can also set it up to automatically change for daylight savings time. You can opt for the GPS system to maintain the date and time automatically, but if you live near a time zone border, you might prefer the manual setting. If you'd like to integrate your compatible smartphone with the vehicle display, you're in luck. With App Connect, you can display and access apps on your phone in the infotainment display using Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, or MirrorLink. You'll find your smartphone's interface virtually mirrored in the display with access to select apps on your phone. To learn more about setup, watch the in-depth tutorial at Know Your Volkswagen. More to come on that later. Of course, you'll need to connect and charge your phone to take advantage of all that technology. Just plug into one of the USB-C ports for charging and data transfer. USB-C only plugs in one way, so you don't have to try and try again. If you have a regular USB cable, Volkswagen offers accessory adapters or USB-C cables at the Volkswagen Accessories website. Or for wireless charging, just place your compatible phone on the charging mat in the console, face up, with no other objects in the compartment. To ensure the device is recognized and has started charging properly, an indicator will appear in the infotainment display. If you're like me, you appreciate the convenience of cruise control. To turn it on, press the cruise control button on the left side of the steering wheel. Once you're at your desired speed, press set. To increase or decrease speed by 1 mile per hour, press the plus or minus button quickly. You can see the set speed in the instrument cluster. Adaptive cruise control is a great feature that not only keeps a set speed, but also maintains distance from a vehicle ahead. Press the adaptive cruise on button on the left side of the steering wheel. You can set the relative distance between your vehicle and a vehicle ahead. Press the distance button repeatedly to choose one of 5 intervals. Press the driver assist button to deactivate adaptive cruise and just use the standard cruise control. This comes in handy if snow or ice blocks the sensors and can't see the vehicles in front of you. The start-stop feature can switch the engine off when you come to a stop. That can help save fuel. The engine starts again automatically when needed. The start-stop function is automatically activated every time the ignition is switched on. The status is shown in the instrument cluster display. To turn the system off, press the start-stop button in the center console. When the indicator light is on, it means the system is off. If you ever see this light come on in your instrument cluster, it means you probably have one or more tires that need attention. If that happens, have the tire pressures checked and adjusted as soon as possible. The correct pressures, or PSIs, can be found on the pillar inside the driver's door. Once they're set correctly, the system needs to be recalibrated. Don't worry, it's easier than it sounds. Press the car button, then settings. Tap the tires function key, then set. Press confirm and you're good to go. Just be sure the tires are inflated to specifications and have them rotated regularly according to the manufacturer's recommendation. We're excited for you to enjoy your new VW with this enhanced knowledge. And we encourage you to dive even deeper into the unique features and benefits of your Volkswagen. How? Glad you asked. Check out knowyourvw.com for videos on just about every feature in your new VW. If you get in a jam, you can always press the CarNet button to connect with Volkswagen resources ready to help. VW customer care is always there if you have any questions about your new vehicle or you just notice something that is not quite right. And since most new Volkswagen vehicles come standard with scheduled carefree maintenance, the first 2 years or 20,000 miles, whichever comes first, of manufacturer recommended maintenance is included. And with our 4 year, 50,000 mile, whichever comes first, bumper to bumper new vehicle limited warranty, you have one less thing to worry about. The more you know about your Volkswagen, the more you'll enjoy all that it has to offer. Now get out there and drive bigger.